Good day, everyone. Today, we will be talking about our first flight test to carry out, which is on the flight controller orientation. For carrying out the tests, we will be using the Betaflight program. However, the steps are similar and can be carried out on any flight program. Let's look at how we can carry out the flight controller orientation. The first step you should take is in the Setup tab. Here, you will find a button that says Calibrate Accelerometer, and this is exactly what you should do. To do this right, you need to make sure your flight controller is stationary on a very level surface. Then click the Calibrate Accelerometer button. After a few seconds, it will complete. It is also essential to check that the Betafly knows the correct orientation of your quad. This could be incorrect at first because the flight controller may be mounted in upside down, back to front, or otherwise misaligned. If you head over to your Setup tab, you will see a 3D model of your quad in the middle of the screen. This should move correctly in relation to how you move it in real life. So if you tilt it down, the 3D model should also tilt down. The green arrow on the 3D render should be on the top of your quad and indicate the forward direction of your quad in real life. It may not point in the same direction as your quad. However, as long as your quad tilts in the correct direction relative to these two reference points, you are okay. If everything looks correct, here you can move on to the next step. If not, you will need to tell the Betaflight the correct orientation. This is done in the Configuration tab, and more specifically in the board and sensor alignment box. You will need to change the angle until the model moves correctly. The most common correction needed is to add some yaw offset. So if the model on the screen rolls when you pitch the quad forward, you will need to change the yaw degrees by 90 degrees. You can correct it by trial and error if you don't know the correct degree change instantly. A useful tip is to use the drop-down box to select a preset angle offset. Remember to hit save and reboot after you make the change. Otherwise, it will reset to defaults after you move off the tab. Thank you.